Did you just download your Articulate Storyline trial and now you're feeling the pressure to build something? Or maybe you've been experimenting and you're looking for some inspiration on what to build next? Well, in today's video, we're going to talk about three projects that you must build in Articulate Storyline to show your ability to create reliable interactions that encourage discovery and learning. Hello, it's Sabrina, and I'm excited to share three storyline projects that you can build today that will make your learners happy to engage with and to learn from. In my last video, I talked about my storyline essentials, and one of those essentials was creating simple projects, a reminder that I definitely needed when I was first starting out. When I was working on my first client project, I got the content from the client and had a sudden rush of imposter syndrome. I felt like I didn't know what to create. I didn't know how to take this content and break it up into something that would be meaningful and effective. Everything that I had learned felt like it was just gone from my brain. But because I had practiced so much creating simple projects, I had these really strong foundational skills to build upon and to lean on in this moment. I was able to take that content and create easy to digest materials and learning experiences using some of the project formats that we're going to talk about in today's video. The three starter projects we're going to talk about today are tab interactions, slider interactions, and click and reveal interactions. It's important to note that adding interaction doesn't necessarily mean learning is happening. Adding interaction and breaking up the content in a way that is easy for the learner to digest is what's going to help us with that learning effectiveness. We will use these project types to deliver content in those nice bite-sized pieces. Let's explore some of the projects. First up, we have tab interactions. So tab interactions allow the learner to explore the content by clicking on tabs or tab-like buttons to reveal any hidden information or to navigate between sections. The tab interactions are used to organize and present content in a structured and interactive manner. So the tabs are going to give us the interactivity where we select the different content, and then the structure comes because it's going to be broken up into smaller sections. Instead of me telling you all about these tab interactions, let's go ahead and take a look at an example. Before we get to the example, I want to let you know that the content you're going to see in all of the examples in today's project is the same content, and that's done on purpose because I want to show you that no matter the content you get, you can deliver it in a variety of different ways. So let's go ahead and take a look at that example. All right, here we have a tab interaction. You can see there's the tabs on the side, and we have our content here broken up. Why would you use a tab interaction? Well, they help organize the content into easily digestible sections, making it easier for learners to navigate and understand complex information. Plus, it gives learners control over their learning experience and can choose which tabs to explore based on their interest or their learning needs. Tab interactions are one of the formats that I use most often, and once you learn how to build a basic version of it, you can start to make it much more unique and change things up and customize it and add some more complexity to your development process. Project number two is a slider interaction. So slider interactions allow learners to adjust a slider control to manipulate the content that's shown on the screen. So as they move the slider, different content shows up. Slider interactions are often used to present information in a more dynamic and engaging way. So instead of just clicking something, we get to slide something, making it a little bit more engaging and more dynamic, so we're getting some movement on the screen. Let's go ahead and take a look at an example. So here we have our slider. We have our title, we have room for some directions, and then we have a starting place. And just like we saw in the tab interactions, we have each of our pieces. So why would you use a slider interaction? Well, it provides learners with interactive controls, increasing engagement. The slider promotes engagement and active participation in the learning process. Also, we get some customization. The slider interaction can be customized to suit the specific needs and objectives of the learning experience, allowing for flexibility and adaptability. So maybe here we can see the content is pretty similar, but maybe we want to chunk the content in a little bit more of a digestible way, I guess. Maybe we have less content here, and then it kind of builds up here and keeps going. We can also make the slider go vertically instead of horizontally. There's lots of ways to customize slider activities. When creating a slider activity, you want to be considerate of the learners and the devices they'll be taking these learning experiences on. So for example, in a slider activity, the thumb or the thing you're sliding, you're going to want it to be larger for people who are on mobile. Our third and final interaction is the click and reveal interaction. So click and reveal interaction is exactly what it sounds like. Learners can click on an object or an area on the screen to reveal some hidden content. And these interactions are often used to present information in a bite-sized and structured way. So the areas where people can click may be a little bit smaller, so the content in those spaces isn't going to be as heavy, right? So you don't want to pack too much and it'd be super tiny and just really overwhelming. And then the structure you have, you can set it up to be like, where they follow a path, different ways to structure how people should click on these, whether they can click anywhere, it doesn't matter which ones they go to, or if you want them to follow a certain path. Let's go ahead and take a look at an example. So here you can see this one has a little bit more going on. There's some animation here, and we have all of our sections here. We have some room for directions and then our title. Again, there's a little bit more going on. We have some animations here. And it doesn't matter where we click, things are gonna flip back over and we see these cards. And if you're like me, when I'm going through all of this content, I want it to go back to how it looked originally. And so you can click off of the cards and it goes back. So why would you wanna use a click and reveal interaction? It's going to help your learners focus, because learners can go ahead and focus on specific areas of interest by choosing which clickable object to interact with and reveal additional content as needed. Click and reveal interactions have lots of room for some special features. Like in the one we just saw, there was animations added, and the animation helps when a learner clicks. It's giving some visual feedback of, you did just click here, there's something happening, here is the content that you were wanting to see. All of the interactions that we looked at today follow the principle of progressive disclosure, or an interaction design pattern that sequences information and actions across several screens, which can reduce cognitive overload and enhance learning comprehension. Building tab, slider, and click and reveal interactions are not only going to help you get familiar with Storyline, but they're also going to help you grow your e-learning development toolkit, create learning experiences that lessen the cognitive load for your learners, and help you grow confidence as an e-learning developer. I hope these project formats and examples spark some ideas for you, and if you'd like to learn how to build one of these projects, then join us this Thursday, March 28th at 10 a.m. Pacific time for a live Storyline workshop where we'll build one of these projects. I'll be joined by Scott Schmidt, our Storyline Pro on the team, and we'll be taking input from the audience. So sign up for the event using the link below, and until then, check out the rest of the Storyline content on this channel. I hope to see you at the live event. Bye!